And it has matrix LED lights.
Hi, Mom.
Hi.
Spoiled little brat.
Jeg troede, at min almindelige tandbørste var god nok, men min tandlæge sagde, at en elektrisk tandbørste er bedre.
Bliv en ekspert med Oral-B el-tandbørste. Oral-B's unikke 3D-bevægelser pulserer for at løsne plak og roterer for at fjerne det.
Nu får jeg den her super rene følelse hver dag.
Bliv en ekspert med Oral-B el-tandbørste.
Jeg bruger aldrig sådan en her igen.
Hvad siger du, skal?
Det er ikke meget.
Jessica isn't happy about the unexpected visitors, but she agrees to let Matthew's friends stay for the weekend.
People knew how to take advantage of her. She was so sweet and so nice.
She liked everybody. She wanted to please everybody. You know, especially men.
Jessica doesn't know it yet, but Andrew and Candace have no jobs, no money. No intention of leaving.
Everyone seemed to get along, but over time their relationship became strained. Candace would Facebook chat or
Discord. Was in the
yeah. Jessica's Facebook updates become increasingly unhappy. Her family noticed the signs that her bipolar disorder is back.
For the last several months, it had been going very well. We saw progress. And then all of a sudden, it just started going downhill again. She became very withdrawn. She became very angry again.
I was seeing the depression coming back. Her more sad and dark side.
Here we go again. What's going on? Why did it change?
Sue decides to find out for herself what is going on.
I knew something was wrong the minute the door was open.
Oh.
Hello.
I wanted to see you. Okay, well, right now's not really a good time. Well, I don't really care about you.
Andrew and Candace have gone out, but Matthew's home.
What's this?
confronted her about the medications and her doctor visits, she kept replying, well, Matthew says I don't need medication. Matthew says I don't have to see a doctor. It was always Matthew this, Matthew that.
I am not going to take the same medications and the side effects from all.
Okay, well, you know what? I don't know about your uncle, but my daughter has severe bipolar and she needs to be taking either medication. Why are you listening to this guy? Because he loves me and he wants the best for me.
We were face to face. We would just feel each other spit. I mean, we really were screaming at each other.
I know what my dog needs, huh?
Oh, really?
Really?
I kept looking at her with that look, like the look of, are you kidding me? And I would. I would turn to her and say, are you kidding me? Really?
Really? Really? The person that gives you unconditional love. He knows you better. Is this what you're choosing, Jessica? This is it.
This is what you want? And she said yes. And I said,
all right. Good luck.
I lost it. I just completely lost it. Everything and anything that I had left in me, I had nothing left.
Jessica pours out her anger on Facebook.
Tuna?
She just expressed how much she hated me.
You're so cool, man.
When I was dead.
Zach.
It's very painful for a parent knowing that their child just hates everything about you. Because you love everything about them.
Sue is now terrified for her daughter's safety. And as more of Matthew's friends descend on Jessica's apartment, life is about to turn even darker.
I still have visions of it. I still have nightmares from that night.
Jessica Sacco's dream of setting up house with her boyfriend Matthew Puccio is being ruined by his two friends.
They're disgusting and they're dirty and I don't want them living in my house. And that needs to happen now.
To make matters worse, Matthew invites two more friends to hang out at Jessica's. Sharon Cook. Chris Wright. Chris is the oldest member of the group and has a history of violence.
We're like the oddballs. The neighborhood.
Matthew and his friends sit around all day surfing the net.
I would describe them as extreme users. They could be sitting in the room with each other, and rather than having a verbal conversation with that person, they would Facebook chat with the person sitting in the room. I would describe it as completely bizarre.
While the others immerse themselves in the net, Jessica, who has not taken her medication for over 2 months now, is becoming more and more bipolar.
I mean, she's disturbed. She was a little, not all there, like a fuse was going off with her.
I can only imagine what she suffered in her head, the demons and what they would tell her.
This is my house.
Why would you let her do that, man? You know we'd be much better off without her.
One member of the group has a real hatred for Jess.
Candace didn't like her. I could sense there was hatred. Supposedly Candace thought that she was hitting on her husband.
Jessica and Candace's relationship was poor at that point, and Candace would communicate how their lives would be so much better with Jessica out of the picture, or if she was dead.
There's so much drama that goes on in that house. It's not safe at that place. Every day she would tell me that, and I don't feel safe.
Jessica knows that things can't continue as they are.
She was desperate to move out.
Oh, yeah.
She says, I really need to leave, and I want to go
conversation, Jessica reaches out to her mom.
She called me up and she just was not herself. She said she wanted to just come home with me.
It's okay, Dad.
What's wrong? You sound upset.
No, I'm fine. I just need, like, a day.
Jess, it's not a good time for me.
Please?
She really was crying out for help, but not directly saying, Mom, I'm in trouble. I need help. She was more subtle about it. Which I do, I carry that guilt of why didn't I pick up on it, but I had a ton of things to do. I just didn't have time.
Friday's not good for me.
Are you sure?
I'm not really busy right now.
Well, okay, then, a friend just said that I can stay with her, like, over the weekend. I don't know, maybe you can give me a ride?
And I said, I can't Thursday, can we do it Friday? I have to work all day. And she said, yeah, sure, no problem.
Sue has been calling Jessica all day, trying to arrange to take her to a friend's house.
Hi, it's Jessica. Leave a message after the woo-woo.
Jess, it's Mom again. Listen, I'm really worried I haven't heard.
It was very, very strange, Jessica not answering her phone. She lived on that phone, and I mean, it was her god.
I called Jessica's phone, and that's when I went straight to voicemail.
Hi.
It really freaked me out. She never turns her phone off. It's always on. When I call, she picks up in a second. There's not one phone call she ever missed from me. I Facebooked her to ask her if she was okay and had the sense that something was up, something wasn't right.
So it was around 7, 8 o'clock that night, and I thought, well, I'll just drop by.
When Sue arrives at Jessica's apartment, it's ominously quiet.
It was not a good vibe. Something was definitely wrong. I try and peek in, but it's pretty dark.
Sue's about to leave when she spots movement inside.
So I knock. Matthew comes to the door.
Hey.
I said, where's Jessica?
She told me she needed a ride, and she's not answering.
No, she left her room. Plug in here, so her battery died.
She's not answering herself. I was supposed to pick her up.
It's amazing what you can convince yourself into and what you can convince yourself out of.
Okay.
I just said, all right, fine.
I guess if she needs a ride, just get her to call me then.
Yeah, for sure. I'll tell her.
Okay.
I wanted to break down the door, but I didn't because she's an adult.
Against her better judgment, Sue goes home. When she returned,
Jessica?
It would be to her worst nightmare.
Everything in that apartment screamed crime scene.
Hvordan computer.
Jo, det ville godt være lidt, hvis han er inden til.
Men det koster faktisk heller ikke ret meget.
Du køber bare.
Ja, slå til nu og køb rentefrit over 36 måneder. For eksempel en MacBook for kun 234 kroner om måneden. Ring til Peter på 8x8 og køb rentefrit.
Damaris.
Søndag. Det er om søndagen, at vi har tid til at drømme om noget større. Den der drømme kommer også an måske en gang. Måske er jeg ikke klar. Måske skulle vi spørge banken. Eller måske bliver det for pressen. Måske.
Drop den måske. På Sunday.dk kan du finde det helt rigtige hjem og få en købsgodkendelse med det samme. Kom ind og få meget mere appetit på julen med gaver fra Imerco. Få flere gaveidéer i en af vores 150 butikker, eller køb allerede nu på imerco.dk.
Cola.
Okay. I just kept telling myself, she'll call, she'll call, she'll call. But it never came.
Sue decides to go back to Jessica's apartment.
Jeg har taget op efter dig.
Hvad?
Jeg siger, jeg har taget op efter dig. Jamen, det kom sådan lige lidt pludselig, eller jeg havde tisse lige sådan, jeg begyndte at give i gang.
Jessica?
Lidt siden jeg gik ud i køkkenet, og jeg tænkte, ej, jeg kan godt lige gøre det færdigt, men så kunne jeg ikke lige være så fundet, så jeg kunne have tisse. Og så skulle jeg mere end tisse. Så det tog lidt at sige.
Nå, piratfesten har også spist den. Den begge to allerede.